I'll never forget the first CD I ever got. Madonna, The Immaculate Collection. Back when Vogue was huge. Strike a pose. Ah, my first CD. I went through it so thoroughly, getting to know each and every track intimately. I also remember when I got Bon Jovi, Slippery When Wet. R.E.M., Automatic for the People. That was a good one. I can still sing along with every song on it. But you know what CDs and tracks I don't remember? The ones I got from BMG Music Club in Columbia House. You know, where you pay just one penny to get 8 CDs. In the end, I got like 12 CDs for a total of 55 bucks after the shipping and all that stuff. Pretty good deal. So I did it over and over. I'm guessing I'm not the only one. And you know what I found? I didn't like it. I never got to know those discs and those tracks nearly as well as the ones I got solo, one disc at a time. When I got one disc with 10 to 12 tracks, I got to know them like the back of my hand. I'd go through them all quickly, then play them one by one, over and over again. Well, Spanish works the same way. If you try to learn too many words at once, you most likely won't learn any of them. I've seen lists and books and courses pages long. How do you know what to focus on? So today's album is called Common Regular AR Verbs, and it has 10 tracks, with a couple bonuses maybe. Hola, soy Jordan, and this is a Spanish quickie. Fast, easy Spanish lessons from somebody who speaks your language. In today's examples, I'll be conjugating some verbs, which I covered in present tense regular AR verbs. So if you haven't seen it, you might want to go back and watch that. Also, in Fun with Words, I covered some pretty common regular AR verbs. Hablar, intentar, and esperar. So I'm not going to waste time on those today. But they were fun for a reason, because there's stuff to figure out. Go back and watch that one too. Okay, we're starting with friends, which we discussed in false friends. They either look like the word we use in English or a relative of the word we use in English. The first word is pasar, which means to pass, and essentially means the same thing. It's just a little more common in Spanish. You can use it to pass the food. Ella pasa la comida. She passes the food. You can use it in any situation where you'd normally say, go ahead. If you and somebody else are both walking up to a door at the same time, you can hold the door and just say, pasa, pass. Another common way they use pasar is no pasa nada, which literally means nothing passes, but it's used when we'd say no problem or it's okay. If you're in the street and somebody bumps into you, then apologizes, you can say no pasa nada, no problem, or it's okay. Next up is necesitar, which is to need. Obviously, this resembles our word necesitate quite a bit, and that's basically what it means. But it's a lot more common in Spanish. Anytime you'd say need in English, you can say necesitar in Spanish. You need to study would be necesitas estudiar. Estudiar is another regular AR verb, which obviously means to study. Remember, I told you in Fun with Words, most English words that start with S, in Spanish, they start with ES. Knowing that, it's really not hard to see study in estudiar. Am I right? Sticking with the friends, regresar means to return, as in come back. Regress in English does mean return or come back, but in the States at least, we usually just use it for self-development. I regressed to my old ways. But in Spanish, they would use that for the more common return from a trip. There are two things I want to warn you about with this word though. There's another common verb out there that basically means the same thing. Volver, an ER verb and not even a regular one, but it is very common and I wondered for a long time what the difference was. The answer is there's really not much of one. Regresar and volver are essentially interchangeable, but neither one can be used to return something to somebody. We'll learn that later. I just messed that up a lot and I don't want you to do the same. You're welcome. Two easy ones in a row now. Terminar is the most common way to say finish or end. I need to finish would be necesito terminar. Anytime you'd say end or finish, you can use terminar. They terminate pretty much everything in Spanish. Then usar, can you guess? Usar is to use. Very easy and straightforward. You use electricity is usas electricidad. Ah, another itty to e dot example. You'll only get that if you saw the video called Fun with Words. Okay, friend time is over, but these are all still regular, very common, and pretty simple. Tomar is to take. You take the suitcase is tomas la maleta. But tomar is often used for drink also. That was really weird for me at first. I learned that drink was beber, and it is. But you'll often also hear people say tomar for drink. You'll often hear a Spanish speaker ask, do you want to take a coffee? Huh? You can learn a lot of Spanish just by paying attention to the mistakes Spanish speakers make when they speak English. Obviously, this works the other way too. So basically, by making mistakes, you're doing them favors. Nice. This next verb verb can be used in many ways, but right now we're focused on the most common. Llegar is to arrive. You arrive in Barcelona? Llegas en Barcelona? Simple enough. This one is handy for all you shoppers. To buy is comprar. I buy a book is compro un libro. We're gonna finish up now with a word that caused a little confusion for me. Preguntar is to ask, like to ask a question. It's nice that the word for question, the noun, is la pregunta. Easy to remember. What tripped me up was asking for something, like ordering food. I'm gonna ask for a chicken sandwich. They would never say preguntar for that. They'd say pedir. Pedir means to ask, as in to order. Preguntar is strictly for asking questions, which is why it's nice that the word for question, the noun, is pregunta. Okay, that's it. Your mission is to go to gringoespanol.com/AR-10, where I have all these words listed nicely for you. I tell you exactly what to put on your flashcards to make it clear and avoid confusion. So go there now, then use the flashcard strategy to memorize these words. All of them are so common to say in normal conversation, especially traveling. So if you spend a half hour or hour really getting these 10 words down, it will not be a waste of your time. The link is also below this video. If you want to make sure you don't miss future videos on Facebook, go to my page, hover over liked, and make sure there's a check next to get notifications. If you're on YouTube, you best subscribe to my channel. And no matter where you are, if you're not a subscriber to the Gringo Espanol newsletter, you're missing out on special stuff and offers not available publicly. So get your butt over to gringoespanol.com/free-updates and become a subscriber. It's free. I will see you next time. Hasta luego. Adios, amigo. You take the suitcase is Tomas la... Woo, yeah.